So let's take a look at this first question here. It says, pyridine, an organic molecule, is a very common weak base. And we should know that it's a weak base because if we take a look at pyridine, it has carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen. Remember, that's an indication that we have an amine. It doesn't have a positive charge on it, so it's a neutral amine, which would make it a weak base. Again, the rules are incredibly important to remember. And in this question, I make it really easy for us. I tell you it's a weak base, but expect your professors not to be that obvious about it. They'll give you a compound and it's up to you to identify it as either an acid or base, weak or strong. All right, so we have a weak base here. It says, assume you have a 0.0225 molar solution of pyridine. Determine its pH. The Kb value for the compound is 1.5 times 10 to the negative 9. Now, we're going to need a lot of room to work this first ice chart out. So I'm going to remove myself from the image, guys, so we have more room to work with. All right, so we know we have a weak base. And I told you, I've said it multiple times. If you have a weak acid or a weak base, we have to use an ice chart. So let's set up this ice chart. We're going to say C5H5N plus water. So I'm just rewriting the equation we have above. And we know this has to be the equation because remember, if this is the base, then the water has to be the acid. So the water has to give away an H positive to the base. The base accepts the H positive, and that's how it became this conjugate acid. The water loses an H positive, and that's how it becomes this conjugate base. Now, we're going to say we're going to do an ice chart, so it's initial change equilibrium. That's what ice stands for. And remember, in an ice chart, we ignore two phases. We ignore solids and liquids. The water is a liquid, so we're going to ignore it. So again, we ignore solids and liquids. Next, we're going to say, since this is an ice chart dealing with acids and bases, we have to have the units in molarity. The good thing is, I already gave you the units, and it is molarity. So if they didn't give it to you in molarity, you'd have to make sure you convert them to that. I don't tell you anything initially about the products, so assume they're zero. Now, here's the important thing. The important sentence you need to remember for acid and base reactions. We lose reactants to make products. So we're losing the reactant, so it's going to be negative X because we don't know what the change is. Remember, it's weak. We don't really know how much of it is breaking down. And if we don't know how much of it's breaking down, we don't know how much product we're making. So this is going to be plus X because they're products, we're making them. Bring down everything. So this is going to be 0.0225 minus X plus X plus X. So we've just filled out our first ice chart for a weak base. Now what we're going to say is, since it's a weak base, bases use KB. So here we're going to say KB equals products over reactants. And I told you the KB value right here. It's 1.5 times 10 to the negative 9. So let's just plug in what we know. This would be 1.5 times 10 to the negative 9. And then we're going to have the products multiplying. Just write the equilibrium expression here. Okay, so this is the equilibrium expression we have. And these two things are X in here and in here. So X times X is X squared divided by 0.0225 minus X. Now, here's the crappy thing about ice charts. Sometimes we have to use the quadratic. The good thing is, when it's acid and base chemistry, we can use a shortcut to see if we can ignore this minus X. If we can ignore that minus X, we don't have to do the quadratic. So to figure out if we can ignore it or not, we're just simply going to do this. We're going to take our initial concentration, our initial concentration is this number, and divide it by our K value, whichever K we're using. In this case, we happen to be using KB. So it'd be over KB. But if we used another question and the value had to be KA, then it'll be the initial divided by KA. We're gonna say if you get an answer greater than 500, then you can ignore the minus X. So just remember that. This is the trick we're going to use to see if we can ignore that minus X. Take the initial concentration divided by the K value we're using. If you get an answer back 500 greater than 500, that means we can ignore that minus X. Because that minus X is going to be so small, it doesn't affect our real answer. So we're going to take the initial concentration, which is 0.0225, and divide it by the K value, 1.5 times 10 to the negative 9. When we do that, we get 1.5 times 10 to the 7. So that answer is incredibly large, much bigger than 500, which would mean we could ignore this minus X. So this is going to make our math a lot easier because now we don't have to do the quadratic. So what we're going to do here is we're going to multiply both sides by 0.0225. So we're going to say now X squared equals 3.375 times 10 to the negative 11. We don't want X squared, we just want X. So take the square root. So X here equals 5.81 times 10 to the negative 6. Now, when it comes to acid-base chemistry, when you find X, X gives you either OH minus or H3O plus. And it's all based on which one is in your equation. In our equation, we have H plus. And at equilibrium, H plus equals X. So what we just found here is the concentration of OH minus. And if we know the concentration of OH minus, we know the pOH. Because remember, pOH equals negative log of OH minus. So plug it in. So here we're going to say here that means that our pOH equals 5.24. But I didn't ask for pOH, I asked for pH. So now you're going to say pH plus pOH equals 14. pH equals 14 minus pOH. So it equals 14 minus 5.24. So your answer here would be 8.76. Now I know it looks like a lot of work, and it is. And you have to be very careful with all the math that you're doing. One little mistake could greatly affect your answer. But this is the way we would set up our ice chart. Now, there's going to be a few variations of different types of questions they can ask. But don't worry, the other videos will cover different varieties of ice charts. This is just our first one. Hopefully you guys didn't get lost along the way as we did this. If you got a little confused here and there, feel free to, if you have to, post a question dealing with it if you have any questions on this one. Or just go back and look at the video again. We know we had a weak base, so we had to do this. The thing is, weak bases produce OH minus as a product. So we have to change our OH minus into pOH, and then from pOH to pH. If we started out with the weak acid, it will produce H3O plus. We'd find X and that would give us H3O plus. And then you simply, to find pH, take the negative log of H3O plus and that will give us pH. Hopefully guys, you guys get really good at these because it does take practice. So make sure you pay attention to all the steps that we're doing.